inspire, empower, grab your girls and soar a little higher, unlock the fire in you, cause real women don't bitch, no, real women don't, 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 real women don't bitch.
Hey, 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 thank you for joining me on the Real Women Don't Bitch podcast. This is your proud host, August Crenshaw, aka Mrs. Raw, Real, and Relentless. I am the number one advanced mental conditioning specialist for entrepreneurs because building mental muscle is necessary in order to implement successful business strategies. This show has been created for the woman who is not excuse-driven and needs help building a profitable business. I will be interviewing women from various fields who are willing to break the silence on struggles that specifically affect female entrepreneurs. Welcome to a show where I and guest speakers from time to time share our methods that help us beast our business no matter what is going on in our lives. Whether you are an online or brick and mortar business owner, this show is for you. We will hit every angle, personal, professional, and spiritual. Why? Because on any given day, you get hit with shit from a scenario involving one, more, or perhaps all of the above. It all impacts you and your mindset towards your business. I have made it my personal mission to provide a space where we dive deep into the BS we face on a day-to-day basis. Hey, beautiful ladies. Man, I'm feeling so groovy. Oh, gosh. So, yeah, I took a break on Monday. If you noticed that there was a podcast episode that wasn't uploaded, and that's because I did the Authentic Collective Summit, and we rocked hard from Wednesday through Saturday, and it was such an emotional and spiritually taxing event that I definitely needed some time to recuperate, and there were no advance recordings. So, you know, hey, sometimes you just got to breathe, you got to chill, but of course, I'm back here wanting to give you your daily nugget slash your inspiration to give you that motivation to keep pushing at what you got going on. And I just really wanted to talk to you about your negative talk about what's possible. And let me be clear. And I had two conversations in particular with women, one locally and one with someone that I had a meeting with over the phone. And they were like, yeah, you know, one of the things with sisters, we just can't work together. We always pulling each other down. We'll never refer each other. We just blah, 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 blah. And you know how it is as a business owner, and people don't want to pay you, and it's hard enough to make money to make ends meet, and so on and so forth. And anyway, and so in speaking to both of these women, it was kind of like, dang, man, everything they were saying was so negative. And I just spent a very blissful 90 days working with 20 other sisters. I mean, so think about this, because for 30 days, there was the gathering of the speakers, the recording of the interviews. But from November the 6th on out, we were working together to promote and put it out there that the event was available. And I did have one incident where one person who was working through some things was just talking about her, some sensitivities with her emotions, but that was just a conversation. We worked through it, and that was it. I'm not saying that there was, you know, no negativity or some things that had to be worked through, but it doesn't have to be such a taxing experience, especially for sisters or women, period, to work together. I'm tired of the stereotypes that we're catty and we don't get along. You know, I at the end of the day, whether you're a man or you're a woman, you're black, you're white, you're Chinese or whatever, there are still always people that just are negative and bring conflict. And I say it all the time. You have to have CEO mentality, which means you take responsibility for any and everything that is going on in your business. And so for me personally, I was just listening to the ladies and I'm like, I wonder how clear they are about their vision. I wonder how many times have they done something just because they were like, okay, well, maybe this will work and it might give me exposure. It might give me more clients. And the whole basis on why they did something was about collection and gain. They didn't really take the time to make sure that the value systems mirrored each other, you know. And so for me, when I'm selecting speakers for my event, it is not just enough for you to fit the mold. So if I'm looking for someone who's an energy healer that can speak on, you know, clarity of mind and spirit and manifestation, I don't need to see that you've been doing the work for 5 years and the testimonials for all of the people that you've helped, as much as I need to actually have a talk with you and ask you questions and vibe with you, you know, and make sure that you are a good fit based on the core things that are important to me. So, like, for instance, I do a live panel discussion at the end of all of my summits, and that means that there needs to be a little bit of, you know, relationship building between the speakers. And so the expectation is for my speakers to get to know each other. And in most summits, the speakers are oblivious to who the other individuals are. And I remember I was talking to someone, and this was for my last summit, and I was like, yeah, you know, sometimes we promote, we do things on live video and so on and so forth. And she was like, yeah, it's no problem for me to do video. I do presentations all the time. And I was listening, and I'm like, I'm talking to you about us engaging together, doing live video, and asking you, are you okay with that? And you're giving me a response of what you've done on the technical side in business. So you look at this as something as just a function and not a bonding opportunity. So I knew that that person was not going to be a good fit for my summit because their value system did not mirror mine. And so I want a lot of you all to just really take that into consideration. Do you think it's hard to collaborate with people? Because honestly, it's not. And if you find it to be difficult and you're the person that's actually hosting the collaborative experience, guess what? That means your leadership skills are being challenged. Let me say that again. If you are at the helm of the experience and it seems like it just never works and women are catty and so on and so forth, then it's time for your leadership skills to improve. And so, you know, there was a lot of energy from the women in the summit. And yeah, they were all connected to the vision and they wanted to make an impact for women healing past their wounds and so on and so forth. But constantly as the driving force, you know, really hammering in what we were doing, why we were doing it, leading by example, by promoting and being about it, reaching out to the women and making sure that they were okay and helping them do things to bond is what changed the energy from, okay, this is something I'm really interested in participating in, to, oh my God, I've got to make sure that every woman that could possibly use this knows about it. And so what are you speaking over your life as far as collaborations are concerned? And if you keep on experiencing those things, you're going to have to do an inner self-check. So that is your nugget for today, because collaboration is critical for all businesses, whether that's you in a partnership or you and a few people doing a deal or you and several people doing and engaging in some type of online virtual summit or other event. It's going to make a big difference in you being able to accelerate more rapidly, but you have to have CEO mentality. So collaboration requires leadership skills. And if you want to see what that looked like, not just so much as the leadership skills, but ladies, if you have said some of these things, you've got some past wounds, and that may not just be because of a relationship gone bad in the business arena. It may be because of your experiences with dealing with women in your family, your mothers, your sisters, your aunts, whatever. I want to encourage you to still sign up for the Authentic Collective Summit. The event itself is no longer live, but the replays are still available, and so is the workbook and some other goodies to go with it. The online virtual event, that live experience on Saturday, those conversations were recorded and they were available. The Capture Your Clients with Live Video 5-day workshop is also included with all of the materials. And so I just really want to encourage you to go to the website. Still go to Real Women All Access. I mean, Real Women, not All Access, augustcrenshaw.com/Real Women. And then go sign up and immediately get the All Access Pass so that you will be able to enjoy and the experience and transform from the women that were speakers in the summit. So anywho, I'm going to get out of here, and you all have a beautiful day. Until later. Deuces.
Thank you for joining me today. Remember to cultivate a mindset that is biased towards taking action. No bitching, whining, or complaining. Here, our mantra is, real women don't bitch, we get shit done. See you next week as I continue to bring you what you need to keep your head in the game and beast your business. Don't forget to hit subscribe and leave us a 5-star review. Would you like a specific topic covered? Have a question you would like answered live? Then head on over to realwomendontbitchpodcast.com. Subscribe to my email list. Hit me up and I got you. Interested in being a guest speaker? You walk the walk? Then you can sign up on the website too. This is your number one advanced mental conditioning specialist for entrepreneurs, Mrs. Raw, Real, and Relentless. Signing out. Deuces!
Inspire, empower, grab your girls and soar a little higher. Unlock the fire in